a mini manufacturing unit in a school in Bengaluru. Wood pulp is being ground with an absorbent material to achieve cotton-like texture and then compressed to produce low-cost sanitary napkins.
At first, the pads are they started from wood pulp and gel tape. They're broken into pieces and they're like grinded, which leads to a biodegradable mixture. This biodegradable mixture is compressed in the compressor, which then is sealed and packed.
According to UNICEF, in rural India, menstruation is the second major reason after household work for girls to miss school. In rural Maharashtra, 60 to 70% of adolescent girls do not attend school during the time of menstruation. Due to a lack in both awareness and availability of affordable sanitary napkins, girls in rural India end up using cloth or straw grass, which causes further health issues. Initiatives like the Sanitary Napkin Project makes these students aware of the problems faced by the less privileged.
As a person who wants to do something good for the community, who wants to make a difference no matter how small or big, this initiative has really helped me become a better person. After producing a pad or two, it gets you thinking about how many women out there don't have access to it and how we are so privileged to actually have something at our disposal.
Having obtained the required license, the school will be soon selling these pads to 6 villages around its campus at a price of 12 to 14 rupees for a pack of 6. While these pads will provide menstrual hygiene to rural women, they are also empowering ammas working on the project and have been aptly named Uran.
Thousands of young girls around the country drop out of school and miss out on education because of the lack of access to a hygienic way to manage their menstrual hygiene. Students here at the Indus International School decided to do something about that problem, and they're making low-cost hygienic sanitary napkins that will soon be distributed free or sold at a very low cost in the area surrounding the school. With DM Kumar, Maya Sharma in Bengaluru for NDTV.